Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight is a very special night for me. My name is C.S. Lewis, the author of the Chronicles of Narnia. This wonderful and creative group of third and fourth graders have rewritten one of my books into their own play. The play is called The Lion, the Witch, and the Murderer. I wrote this book in 1950 when I was 52 years old. I died at the age of 65. If I was alive today, I would be 97 years old. This charming adventure story made me achieve enormous success. With that in mind, I wish each and every one of these lovely, bright children good luck in their production. Thank you all for attending this evening. Now on with the show. We would like to begin by playing this music to our song, Kid. To the song, Care Paramount, which we will ask you to sing with us at the ending of our play. Also, you will hear Miss Katie McDonald, a fourth grader, speak on why she couldn't make it tonight. We all miss her presence in this evening. This first act shows four children being sent away from London in 1940 during the war because of the Aryans. They are sent to the house of an old professor who lived in the heart of the country. He is 10 miles away from the nearest railway station.
Thank you. Good luck. Okay.
I'll make
you a daughter of Eve?
What do you mean?
I mean, are you a girl? In fact, a human?
Of course I'm a girl. Girls are human.
Oh, how stupid of me. It's just I've never seen a daughter of Eve or a son of Adam before.
Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Thomas.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Thomas.
Have you seen this in Narnia?
What's that?
This is the land of Narnia. All that life between the land of the great castle of Caracarabella and the eastern sea.
It's winter here and never
thank you.
It is the next day and it's raining again. Lucy and Susan are putting a puzzle together. Peter is reading and Edmund is pacing back and forth. He is frustrated with not being out and being able to go outside.
I hate this. The question is so boring.
Have you ever prayed in Narnia before?
Well, my sister said.
Two, she's calling Daddy. And three, she's telling the truth. And one, you know she's not telling a lie because Lucy was in the water. And two, you know she's not lying because she tells me her name is Lucy every day. So the only possibility is three, that she's telling the truth.
Get out and have some
Side.
human sentiment.
Let them try to get Asmin! You have a treat up there! be here, maybe we can see if just what all the buzz is all about. We've got an emergency meeting.
Why don't you take?
Oh, I've got some soup on the heating.
Do you think we'll stay late?
Who would you be hungry?
Well,
I guess we'll see what we'll see.
If we're together, no matter.
Standing out in the cold, it's easy to contract pneumonia.
Well, I don't want New York to be cold or to
contract anything. Maybe we should ask Christopher Robin about a house for Eeyore. But where is Christopher Robin anyway?
He should be here. He called this emergency meeting.
And to think wherever Owl is, she'd come home sometime. But there's no sign of her. And her curtains are all pulled down.
Perhaps Owl is sleeping. Owl sleeps far too much, if you ask me. It's unhealthy to take so many naps in the daytime.
Well, I can come up and ring her doorbell.
Well, don't anybody look at me. I won't go up there. Nobody ever does any favors for me, so why should I risk my bones for them? Standing all night, the cold passes with the snow getting in my ears. And nobody cares. Absolutely no one.
Well, I said we'd take it up at the emergency meeting, Eeyore. Hey, I think I hear someone coming.
Ooh, maybe it's Owl. Or Christopher Robin. Oh, no. It's one of my nieces and one of my nephews. I have 29 in all, you know. This is last time I count. I can't keep track.
I'm early. I'm late.
Oh, we see that, dear, but Christopher Robin and Owl are even later still.
I mean, that's my name, Lady Rabbit.
Oh, well, better late than never, I always say. Oh, look, there he is.
I'm sorry to be late, but, well, they took me into town to buy a new suit. And, well, that's part of what the emergency meeting's about.
Hard.
Quiet, please! Oh,
the emergency meeting has been called to order.
Without Owl?
Oh, yes, we should wait for Owl. We'll need her advice. But maybe we shouldn't wait, since this is a real emergency.
What's a real emergency, Christopher Robin?
It's when something dreadful has happened, and it's going to get worse unless you do something fast.
Something dreadful happened?
They're sending me away to education.
I don't want to go one bit. Oh, did you tell them that?
Yes.
There are interesting things to learn out there. There are places where big things happen. There are trains and boats to take you there. But there's only one place with a small furry bear. There's a city up here at the end. That is better than the throne of England. I don't care if all the coffee comes directly from Brazil, when all the friends I care about are here. I don't care if all the coffee comes directly from Brazil, when all the friends I care about, all the friends I care about, all the friends I care about are here.
Uh-huh. Well, I'm sure it's a much better sitting stone than Brazil ever sat on, even if she does have so much coffee.
Brazil's just a place, Piglet. It doesn't sit.
No brains, no brains. Just muff.
Oh. Hello, Eeyore. How are you?
About the same. Just thinking about cold pastures when it's late at night. Of course, no one cares if I freeze to death. Who cares about the problems of poor old Eeyore?
Oh, Eeyore, I never thought about you not having a house.
Oh, that's all right. I'm used to being forgotten. I only hope that they remember that you need a house to be educated.
But we can't let them send Christopher Robin away.
Oh. But we don't need another problem. And what with Eeyore wanting a house so much, I don't see how I could possibly go up to education. I shall simply tell them that I have to stay here to build Eeyore a house. Oh, but where?
Doesn't matter where they put my house. No one will ever visit me anyway.
Christopher Robin.
Come in.
Oh, I wish Owl were here to help with the planning. It's not like her to miss emergency meeting.
Perhaps Owl has emergency too.
Christopher Robin, you must come.
Well, now I'll have to go and explain to them.
Well, why not tell them that something unforeseen will prevent you going?
But you have no idea, Boo, how hard it is to explain anything to them. They say things like, it's definite.
What does it's definite mean?
Well, it means stop talking about it.
Coming!
Well, you can go on with the rest of the planning, and wait for me, and I'll report back.
I feel better about planning. If Owl were here, she's so wise and experienced.
Oh, I think we can carry on. The first thing to do is appoint a commission. I'll be the chair.
Oh, what for?
To draw up plans for Eeyore's house.
Nothing but love.
First, she'll need a nice bright kitchen to cook in.
Cook what? I eat thistles, and I don't want anyone to spoil them by cooking them.
Oh, very well. My opinion is not wanted here. Rue and I was simply... Rue! Your hand! Your face!
Oh, my goodness!
Come along, we'll wash that nasty stuff off at once.
But it's not nasty.
You have a lovely bath, dear.
Now, Eeyore, the first thing your house will need is an attractive entrance. Perhaps with a fan light.
No, the first thing I need is a shelter, and that's all I need. The trouble with you, Rabbit, is that you're always down a whole word. You should try standing in
a cold pasture.
Ooh, what do you mean, the morning?
I should!
Very well. Make fun of your elders. I'm accustomed to ridicule, because nobody cares about me.
Christopher Robin.
Yes?
Remember, I want you back here in 10 minutes, no more.
All right. His voice sounds awfully queer, like he's been crying.
Uh-huh. They said it's definite?
Well, did you explain about Eeyore's house?
Well, I tried to. But they just kept saying, never mind that, as if it matters before Eeyore gets pneumonia.
Everybody feels the same. They all hate me.
Oh, I don't, Eeyore. I love you. All of you. Oh, I just can't leave you all out here with no one to look after you. But to listen to them, you think nothing in the whole world matters except education.
Well, did you get mad?
No. I'm perfectly calm. I told them I'm quite educated enough already. I know my ABCs, and I can spell small words very well.
Oh, and if you want to spell words like back soon, I'll help you when she gets back. She can spell Tuesday ever so many different ways.
And as for counting and subtracting,
well, there's no problem there. I can easily count to 15. Otherwise, how could I keep track of my 15 jars of honey?
Oh, and as for subtracting, we'll subtract Eeyore from her cold pasture, and she'll be happy. She'll be laughing and singing and telling jokes. Well, maybe not jokes.
No, not without Christopher Robin here to help us. We won't do all that.
I knew nothing would come of it.
You know what the worst part is? They wouldn't even listen. They just kept saying, there'll be no further discussion.
What does that mean?
Well, they think it means I've got to go.
Well, don't you?
Not if we all run away.
See, oh, yes.
I brought some bananas. Now, we can just pack these and leave.
Packing this?
Oh, how?
Silly! Anyone who runs away always packs a bandana. You put all of your things in the middle, you tie up the end, and then you put it all over a stick. It's the correct thing to do.
Well, where should we run to?
Well, I thought perhaps to the North Pole.
Yes, the North Pole!
Oh, no. There are crocodiles there.
Oh, no.
Well, then let's run to the South Pole.
Christopher Robin and I discovered the South Pole. It's very far away, way on the other side of the blackberry patch.
Now, we must plan carefully what to take. Well, we'll need several chocolate bars.
Yummy!
Chocolate bars? Well, explorers always take chocolate bars. And we'll need our galoshes.
Oh, good!
Well, what's it like at the South Pole?
Oh, it's very beautiful. Christopher Robin says it's an enchanted place.
What does enchanted mean, Mama?
Well, there's a magical place right in front of your nose that is seen only when you desire it. All it takes is some friends that you love very much with a single idea.
Christopher Robin and what they might have done to him. And look, it is a quarter to four.
Climb that
figure a way to climb a tree.
Oh, Gran, is it Tigger Grandmama?
Owl won't like this.
We don't visit Owl unless we're invited.
Hey, Owl's peeking through our curtains.
Oh, don't forget, Owl is very wise.
Huh? Tiggers are wiser.
What a splendid climbing Tigger. Look, Mama, he's knocking on Owl's door. Perhaps the door is locked. Tigger, don't knock so hard.
Hello?
Well, I may as well unpack my dust cloth.
yet to finish.
Oh. Perhaps if Pooh had waxed his chair, it would have protected it from Tigger.
Oh, I don't think wax works against Tiggers.
Hurry, lady, would you get my in and out basket, please? Attention, everyone! Attention! Gather around. Right this way with the in and out basket, that's it. Now, we shall put all items that can still be used into the in basket. The in basket. All items that are broken, we shall put into the out basket. The out basket. In, out. Say it with me.
In,
out. Very good. Now, Pooh and Piglet are already working on Eeyore's house, and once we've got this mess cleaned up, then we can begin to repair Owl's house.
Take them. Help yourself.
Are these really thistles?
Oh, no brains. No brains. Just water.
What Tigger's like best?
Yes, uh-huh.
Oh. I see.
Excuse me, or I beg your pardon.
being taught a lesson.
What could we teach him?
A lesson you'll never forget.
Teach how to die.
You could have learned how to avoid
you.
Can
you stand? What? I think I have it.
What does Owl have?
An idea.
We will unlouse Tigger and teach him a much needed lesson.
How will we do that, Owl?
Simply. We'll simply take him on a long explore.
And explore to the North Pole.
Somewhere he's never been. And then we'll lose him there and come back without him.
Poor Tigger.
After a few days at the North Pole, he will be a very humble Tigger.
A small, cold Tigger.
Oh, sadder but wiser Tigger.
A very hungry Tigger.
And a very dirty Tigger.
It was a very long explore for Christopher Robin and I driving the North Pole. So should it. It should be a very long explore for Tigger I'm finding.
Yes. But supposing Tigger doesn't want to go on an explore?
Leave that to me. I'll organize it.
As soon as Rabbit is back from organizing, the rest of us shall lose Tigger in a wise and thoughtful fashion.
Yes. And twice on Thursday.
Huh?
Very near the North Pole. And I fear that there may be crocodiles in the stream. Oh, if they should slip on one of the stones, they may be eaten.
Oh, I sure hate it if Piggle were eaten. He squeaks so when he's scared.
You know, it's strange. They didn't mention the explore to me.
Oh, you weren't here. Yeah. Perhaps we should look for them first thing in the morning.
But I'm leaving. This evening. Man, I've got to say goodbye to all my friends.
No! Then we've got to find them! But how can we? Without Rabbit to organize the search.
Well, you can't always depend on others, Tigger. Now, I've learned that much even without education. There simply comes a time when you have to do your best without any help.
Tiggers are big helpers!
Oh, well, we'll have to hurry.
I'll sniff the air!
Tigers are very good snippers when the wind is right.
Tigger!
Hey!
Oh. I didn't get lost! It was the best of us that got lost instead!
Oh, it looks like we all need a good scrubbing. Oh, come on, dear.
Oh, I thought we would never find our way through that bramble patch.
But the brambles are quite refreshing. Delicious eating.
Where have you all been?
Well, it's like this, Christopher Robin. There was a problem on Tigger.
And there was a slight mistake of a wrong turn.
It happens to the best of us.
Actually, we could not find the North Pole, nor even the South Pole.
Well, where's Pooh?
Oh, Pooh is still lost. But it was Tigger who was supposed to get lost.
Yes. What happened to you, Tigger?
Nothing happened to me. Nothing ever happens to us Tiggers.
Pooh Bear?
When was the last time you remember seeing Pooh?
When he was right behind me, when we crossed the little meadow.
And I saw him walking by the big fallen tree.
We must organize a search for Pooh.
Yes. And we've got to hurry. Oh, but I'm afraid if Pooh is near the big fallen tree, he may have smelled honey. And when Pooh smells honey, it means he may be gone for days and days. Oh, no, he mustn't be, Piglet. I'm leaving right away.
Well, just how long is right away?
Well, in this case, it's about an hour.
Oh.
Is that about a year?
Well, actually, it's 60 minutes. 60? So when you hold up all your fingers and thumbs 6 times.
What the hell cares about 60? I mean, you can't eat 60.
We care.
Of course we care.
We all care. Don't be Christopher.
Well, I hope you do.
Yeah.
I don't.
Well, that's because I really haven't had time to educate you, Tigger.
No.
I'm afraid that's why you're so noisy and bouncy and headed so much.
It's not a Tigger that doesn't bounce. It's a very unhappy Tigger. And I'd like to be happy.
Well, we want you to be happy, Tigger.
Yes, but quietly.
You mean, you really like me?
You really want me to be happy?
Yes, we love you, Tigger.
Oh, well, don't we, Owl?
Well, at some times, and at some parts, and in some ways, but education is education, and you can't change that.
Ah, oh, they love me! They love me! I'm in love, Tigger! I'm in much love, Tigger!
That's right. Attack me.
Excuse me, quickly! I didn't mean to hurt you, Leor.
And not meaning to doesn't count.
What counts is not meaning to and not doing.
My words exactly.
Oh, it will be dreadful if I don't get to say goodbye to Pooh.
You mean he'll go, Christopher Robin? Even if Pooh stays lost?
That's right.
And no matter what happens in the woods, you'll still leave?
That's right.
Oh, Pooh! Pooh, come quick! Oh.
I really hope Pooh isn't hiding up. That really wasn't in the plan.
You mean Pooh doesn't want to say goodbye to Meow?
I mean that maybe Pooh thinks that if he isn't around for anyone to say goodbye to, maybe nobody will go away.
Oh, Pooh, come home!
I'll look for him, Christopher Robin! I will sniff everywhere and look under every tree trunk!
Well, I'll fly over the meadows and Eeyore can look through the deep woods.
Oh, and I can wait here in case he comes back.
Wait! I think I smell a Pooh Bear smell.
Well, what does he smell like? Honey?
Now I smell it closer.
Do you really smell something, Tigger?
Oh, yes. I smell honey and sort of a dampish, pondish smell.
Well, I found some honey, and then
I fell in the brook and lost it all.
Oh, clumsy. Very clumsy.
Christopher Robin has been waiting to say goodbye to you.
And I expect he needs to say goodbye forever.
Oh, no, not forever, Eeyore. Well, I'll have lots of vacations. I can see you all then.
You mean you're going right now?
Well, not quite. See, there's still one more thing I have to see to before I leave. There's the problem of Tigger.
Huh? But I want to stay in the woods. I love the woods. Don't I, Roo?
Yes, certainly. Tigger loves the woods.
Yes, but you aren't educated, Tigger. And so you just go ahead and do whatever you want to without caring what happens.
My very words. Tigger doesn't even try to spell Tuesday.
Oh. And he doesn't care about six.
But I don't care. But look how much I care.
Oh, Tigger, here's why. Look what happens to Roo's medicine with Tigger around. Only part of a bottle left. You see, Tigger, here just one fountain in my doggy's bill.
I promise I'll be careful.
But what about what happened to my house now?
Christopher Robin, he has stuff for brains. He can't be educated.
And look at what happened to my broken fortune.
Oh, I'm afraid that settles it, Tigger. I'll have to put you up in my room.
No! Not the closet shelf! All alone! On the shelf!
Well, perhaps instead I could put you in my bureau drawer.
No!
And if you'll try to be quiet and refined...
I'll be so quiet, you're fine!
Maybe
best is just doing what you're doing, only a little better, of course.
Well, I think you'd have to do something besides what you're doing, and you'd have to do it quite well.
Like rebuilding Eeyore's house.
Yes.
I move that Pooh sit on the sitting stump as chair.
Oh, probably nice.
Oh, all right. I'll take your seats, please. Quickly, come on. Okay. Attention, everyone. The emergency meeting is still convened.
Pooh is a wonderful chairman.
But I don't know what the real emergency about. Now that we talked so much about Tigger.
Well, emergency is your house, Eeyore. And this committee does not intend that tomorrow at 3 o'clock in the morning you be standing
in the hall.
If you really mean it, then.
Well, then, let's all get to work.
Well, first, we must organize.
Must we?
Well, I propose this organization. All will carry wood until Eeyore's house is ready. 1, 2, 3, start!
We had an emergency meeting. Now we know just what to do.
She likes it, Piglet.
Oh, her eyes are closed. I believe she's falling asleep.
All right, then. We'll let her get some sleep. Poor Eeyore. Good night, everyone.
Good night, Pooh dear. Come along, Pooh dear. We'll have a nice malt extract. Perhaps your friend Tigger would like to come along with us. Taking Tigger home with us? Certainly, dear. He needs to be somewhere where he can have motherly supervision. Come on. You'll each have a lovely bath and some strengthening medicine. On tiptoe, please. We mustn't wait for Eeyore.
Where the rain of spirit stops, and they will never know.
go, Jay's Sparrow. Sing the song, don't be long, reel me to the...
The reason for this I really want to put out there is that we did read the line in which the wardrobe, and they were enthusiastic about it. But what I wanted to get across to these kids is that they need to be proud of who and what they are in the moment and at 9 and 10 years old, and not to wait and think that they have to get older to achieve something. And as we know tonight, we can always improve and get better, which is a learning experience all in itself, as well as I can as a teacher. So I'm really proud of all of them for everything. They did come up with, in the program, in cooperative groups, they came up with 50 spelling words out of the Lion, Witch, and the Wardrobe, and definitely challenged themselves. I'm really proud of all of them. There are some children here that got 25 wrong the first time and got down to 6 wrong. And if I can, you know, feel a lot of praise for those children, you know, they really tried hard to improve. So I thank them. But I'm also very impressed by these children too. These children got 100% on all 50 words, and I don't know if you looked into your program, but we had reindeer, patience, care, paravel, wardrobe, extraordinary, particularly, possibilities, passageway, consideration. I'm just really impressed with them. And the first person, and their award, of course, is to go out to dinner with me and go to a movie. I was going to buy them dictionaries, but I figured why.
Production for all of you. We thank you very much for coming.
My life and before